The Athena project is about helping airports integrate new technologies in order to improve the efficiency of their operations.
Finding a way to coordinate the movement of people, freight, while maximizing the productivity of energy, we feel is a very beneficial approach for achieving sustainable development in the future.
So it gives us an opportunity to look at the energy impacts of some of these new disruptive transportation models, like ride sharing and car sharing, and the impact that can have, in this case, on airports.
So we think that autonomous vehicles are arriving, you know, any day now, and we think that electric vehicles are growing very rapidly. We think that maybe drone flights will be cruising around our cities, carrying people around. And so what we need to do is consider a lot of different scenarios and see how that might impact a port.
When you're deciding to go to the airport and how are you going to get there, you might decide, okay, I'm going to drive and park, or I'm going to have somebody drop me off, I'm going to ride a bus, I'm going to get a taxi, I'm taking a rental car. Those choices are all based on certain characteristics of the person. What's their age? What's their income level? Are they traveling for business? Are they traveling for pleasure? Even things like age and gender. We need to be able to understand how does that work now, and also how will it work as the technologies change, as the population changes.
I'm really interested in learning about what other airports are doing and how they can use this project as a model to improve sustainability initiatives that they have. And I'd like to take some of those lessons learned back to our airports and share them back with my colleagues.
What excites me about this research is the amount of stakeholders that are a part of this project. The variety of stakeholders will really ensure the success of such a great tool.
NREL and Oak Ridge National Laboratory bring together a wealth of data scientists that are top experts in their respective fields.
National labs have a great deal of expertise that a typical company might not have.
They fill in gaps where industry doesn't have the access to things like some of the high performance computing and some of the resources or the equipment that the national labs have.
I think the most exciting thing about this project is the fact that we're actually going to make a meaningful change in the way that ports operate.